And CUDA, this discussion focuses on the concept of a warp. Now remember that a warp is a set of threads that operate in lockstep, all executing the same instruction at the same time on whatever data they happen to be processing. And its general technique is called SIMD, that stands for Single Instruction Multiple Data. This is a term you'll hear a lot in parallel computing. Computer architects have been building SIMD processors for decades. It saves a lot of transistors and a lot of power if you can amortize the work used to decode and fetch and perform a single instruction against multiple pieces of data at once. All modern CPUs use vector instructions, and the most typical one on Intel CPUs are called SSC or AVX instruction sets. And these are ways that the CPU can execute the same instruction on multiple pieces of data at once. And going back to a point I made at the very beginning of this lecture, on the CPU, if you're performing an SSC instruction, you're using, in a single clock cycle, you're affecting 4 pieces of data. On AVX, you could be affecting 8 pieces of data. These vector registers represent a huge amount of the computational horsepower, and if you're not using them on the CPU, then you're missing most of the power of your processor. Another term you'll see a lot is SIMT. This is a term coined by NVIDIA to stand for Single Instruction Multiple Threads. And this is a subtle distinction that has to do with what happens when there is thread divergence. Let me explain what that means. It all comes down to what happens at a branch in the code. Here's some code with an if-else statement. And I'll color the instruction stream black for instructions that all the threads are going to execute, red for instructions that only threads that take this branch in the if statement will execute, blue for instructions that only threads that take the else branch will execute, and black again